Do you have information that mysteriously disappears when you convert your leads into accounts, contacts, and deals? Hi, my name is Zach Spader, and I'm with Cornerstone Solutions. And today I'm going to show you how to use the lead conversion mapping feature in Zoho CRM. Let's take a look. Okay, so we're in my demo account right now, and I'm going to click on the setup icon, which is the gear icon up in the top right-hand corner. And let's go to modules and fields under customization. And then I'm going to hover over the leads module, and this little menu pops up. I'm going to choose lead conversion mapping. So this is where all the mapping happens. And you'll notice that on the left-hand side, all the lead fields are listed. And then you have the account, contact, and deal modules with fields that you can select the field that you want to map to in those modules. So you can see that there's a whole bunch of mapping that's done already. All the default fields like revenue, city, country, these are all mapped already into these separate modules for you. But most people want to create custom fields in their lead module to capture certain types of data. And then you want to be able to map that over as well. So we're going to back up for a second and hit the cancel button here. And then we're going to go into the leads module. So let's say I want to create a new field and I want to call it number of users. It's going to be a number field. And so I can choose the number field. I can drag it onto my layout here. And I'm just going to rename this number of users. Okay. Now, normally when you're creating a field, you would create the field and then you would save the record here. But before I do that, I'm going to select the three little dots here, the little ellipsis, and select edit properties. And I have an option down here that says also create for account, contact, and deal. So in this instance, I can choose which other fields that I want to, or which other modules that I want to add these fields to. So I want to add it to the account and the deal module. So it's going to go ahead and create this number of users field in those modules. So if I click done here, I'm going to save. And then if I back out of the leads module, and let's say I go to the accounts module, you can see that in accounts, I have a field called number of users, and it always gets added to this top information section at the bottom of that section here. So number of users, and I can see that that field has been added. And if I go to deals, same thing, right up in the top section, number of users. Now, if I back up, let's go back to the lead module again, and I go back to the lead conversion mapping. If I look for that field, here's number of users, and I can see that because when I created the field, I created it in accounts and deals as well, it auto maps that for me. So when you're creating new fields in the leads module, it's always a good idea. It saves you a little bit of time if you create the fields in your account, contact, or deal module at the same time, and then it pre-maps it for you. But maybe you've already created some fields in your lead module and you forgot to create them for accounts, contacts, or deals, or you decide later on that you want to push that field into those modules. So let's go back for a second. We'll hit the cancel button here. We'll go back into leads. And now I'm going to say, let's add another field in. Let's call this number of decision makers. Okay. And then let's say I forget to create that field in the other modules. And so I just save this. And you'll see after I save it, I don't have that option anymore. So I'm going to show you how we're going to do that now. So what I'm going to do, if I have to recreate this field, I'm just going to copy the name here and I'm going to back up. I'll go into the account module. And then I can just choose my number field again and drag this in here. And then I'm just going to copy paste and I'll save this record. And then if I wanted my deal module as well, I can go into my deal module. All Okay, so I've got this created in accounts and deals now. Now I want to map it. So I'll go back and I'm going to go back to the leads module, hover over my layout here and click lead conversion mapping again. And scroll down and now see I have my number of decision makers, but it's not mapped. See, it doesn't automatically map it because we didn't create them when we created the lead field. So now on the account record, I'm going to select this and you can see that the number of fields that I have as options are limited. And like we mentioned before, you have to make sure that the field types are the same. So it's only showing me field types in the account module that I can possibly map to. So I'm going to click the number of decision makers here. I'm going to do the same thing for the deal module, number of decision makers, and save that. Okay, so now the number of decision makers is mapped from the lead module upon conversion into accounts and deals. Okay, so let's show one other thing real quick. I'm going to back up. I'm going to create a field. Let's create one more field here. And let's say I'm going to use a single line field this time. So instead of using a number field, I've used a single line text field. And I'm going to say number of contacts. Okay. This field really should be created as a number field, but if you created it as a single line field, that's okay. But I just want to show you how you can't map different field types to each other. So if I save this record here, then let's say that I go into the account module and I want to create the same field, but in this module, let's say that I use a number field instead. So we have a number contacts. I'm going to save that. Okay, now if I back up, go back to my lead module, I'm going to go back to lead conversion mapping. I'm going to scroll down here. We have the number of contacts. And so I created the same, a field in the account module, but I didn't use the same field type. And you see that when I click on number of contacts here now, it doesn't have a matching field for me to select because it was a different field type. Just wanted to show you that you need to make sure that the information that you're mapping is the exact same type of field type. There is one other scenario that's kind of a niche scenario that I'll show you as well. If you're in the lead module and you choose a currency field, let's say I add a new currency field to my record here. We'll call it monthly revenue. In a currency field, you have a bunch of options for the number of digits that can be allowed, the number of decimal places, and the rounding option. If you create a currency field in your lead module, and let's say that you choose a maximum of 5 digits here. If you recreate this currency field in the account, contact, or deal module that you want to map, you need to make sure that all of the specifications for that number are exactly the same. So like you can't map 16 digits currency field to a 5-digit currency field. The numbers have to be exactly the same for you to be able to map them. Now, if you create the field in the account, contact, or deal module when you're creating the lead field, then you're fine. It'll use the exact same specifications to create those fields in those modules. But if you come back afterwards and you create a currency field after the fact, you have to make sure that these numbers are exactly the same here. All right. So there's one other scenario that I want to show you real quick here. I'm going to go ahead and let's not save that field. And I'm going to let's cancel out of this. In all of your modules, you do have the ability to create different layouts. And so for my lead module here, I have the standard layout. But let's say that I want to create a separate type of layout for a different type of lead. So I'm going to go ahead and clone this, and we'll call this layout the alternate layout. You define who has access to this layout. Okay. Now, let's say that the alternate layout leads need to map to the an alternate layout deals as well. So I go to the deal module, I have the standard layout, I can clone this layout, and we'll call this alternate as well. Okay, so now in the leads module and the deals module, I have a standard and an alternate layout. So in my leads, if I go back to leads and I hover over one of the leads, the layouts here, I have the lead conversion mapping option. And you notice when I select it from the layout, up here at the top, this section looks a little bit different. And now I have I'm doing the conversion mapping for just the alternate layout. And so you can see here that it pre-chose this alternate layout for me. And so I can come in here over to the deal module, because the deal's the only other module that I have another layout. And I can actually select that I want to map from the alternate lead layout to the alternate deal layout as well. And I can save that. So if I go back to the lead module here and I select the standard and then lead conversion mapping, you can see that it automatically selects the standard layout here, and then it's already mapped to the standard deal. So that's fine. Now, if I cancel out of this, I'm going to back up just one step here to this screen where I have the modules listed. If I hover over leads here and select lead conversion mapping, you can see that now instead of selecting the layout for me, I have the option of choosing between the two of them. So that's the difference between if you're on this screen, you hover over leads and you choose lead conversion mapping, versus if you were to click leads here and then go to the layout and select lead conversion mapping from the layout. If you do it from the layout here, it automatically selects the layout that you were hovering over. If you do it from the module, then it lets you pick which layout that you want to map to. And of course, if you have different layouts, so let's say you have the standard layout mapping to the standard deal, you can have different mapping. You can have a whole different mapping than you have to in your alternate layout. So let's say that in the standard, instead of mapping to the billing city, you want to map to the shipping city. So you can choose shipping city and let's say shipping country, and then you save that. And you can see when we do that, then if I choose the other layout, the alternate layout, it hasn't affected the alternate layout. So you can have completely different mappings for the two different types of layouts. Hope this video has been helpful. Hopefully it showed you how to use the lead conversion mapping, whether you're creating new fields or whether you're going back to fields that are already created and mapping them over. So hopefully this video has helped you. Have a great day. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.